So this effect isn't completely original. It was inspired from Practical Mental Effects by Ted Annemann, a very famous mentalist of his day of the 1940s. He came up with literally hundreds and probably thousands of effects that he used in his mentalism shows as well, which he shared with the magic fraternity. And this really spoke to me when I first was getting into magic in the early 1970s, I guess it was, and I never forgot this effect, and I'm honored and thankful to be able to share it with you all today. So what we're going to do is we're going to use a deck of playing cards, and I'm going to select, actually I can show all of you as well, that they're all different, well mixed. We could even shuffle them up, it really doesn't matter. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a marker to write a prediction in the corner. Wow, this thing really smells. You gonna smell that? That's just another bonus of being a magician. And there we go. We'll make the ink dry, or encourage it to dry. And we will place it just down here like so. And now what I'm going to get you to do is I'm going to get you, if you will, to select a card from this whole deck of 52 cards. Well, now there's 51 because we have an impromptu prediction there. I'm going to get you to touch the back of any one of those cards. That one right there, just push it out a bit. There we go, without looking at it, without sharing it with anyone else, and without anyone at home knowing what that card is as well. And just a reminder as well, she could have picked any one of these 52 cards. Now the cool thing about this is, it's a perfectly free choice, A. B, it's a full deck of 52 cards, and all you're using is the deck and the marker. So, one of these cards is the prediction that I wrote, and I wrote on the corner two of clubs, and lo and behold, the one card in 52 that was pulled supposedly at random, the two of clubs as well.
Thank you.
this one is called Clipped Revelation. It can be as an open prediction or a closed prediction. I'll show you in a second. So we're going to use a deck of cards, deck of 52 playing cards. And what I'm going to get you to do is I'm going to get you to touch the backs of one of these 52 cards. Now, I've already made a prediction, so there's some kind of subliminal or subconscious, if you will, suggestion for that. We're going to use a jumbo card, and as well, we're going to use a paper clip, hence the name Clipped Prediction. And so now, we'll shuffle up the cards a bit, and we'll spread them out. And I'd like you to touch the back of any one of those cards. Excellent. Just push it forward a bit, just so that this is very fair. So it was that one right there. And you could have picked any one of these 52 playing cards. You chose to select this one. And what we're going to do is we're going to place this against the back of the prediction and clip it so that it can't go anywhere. Now again, just to recap, open prediction, could have been any one of these 52 cards. I predicted that you'd select the Nine of Diamonds, and believe it or not, you did indeed select the Nine of Diamonds. And we're going to try that again, but this time what we're going to do is it's not going to be an open prediction, it's going to be a closed prediction. Again, we're going to use the one card and the paper clip. This one is referred to as closed prediction. Again, you're going to select one of these 52 playing cards. And again, all different. Shuffle them up, like so. And we'll spread them out. I'd like to get you to touch the back of any one of those cards. And to gently push it forward without looking at it and without sharing it with anybody. Oh, it's slippery. So you could have selected any one of these 52 cards. You selected this one. I'm going to place this one in front of the prediction. I'm going to clip it as well, hence the name Clipped Prediction. Perhaps there was a suggestion on a subliminal level of one of those cards for you to select. You had no idea what card you were to actually pick, what I was inferring. But let's have a look and see what card in 52 that you did pick. It is indeed the Queen of Diamonds, the same prediction made. It's called Clipped Revelation. It can be as an open prediction or a closed prediction. And this next one is referred to as the Holy Card, and it was written up in one of the magic trade journals some years ago. And I think you'll like it because the methodology also enables one to do more than one card effect. So we're going to right now share with you two very, very different effects utilizing the same methodology. So first, the Holy Card. So what we're going to do, we'll open up the pack like so, and we'll pull out a pack of playing cards. And I'm going to ask you, Susan, if you will, to say stop as I riffle through the cards. Go for it.
Stop.
Right there. This is the card that we're all to remember. And what we'll do is we'll cut the pack a little bit to bury it into the middle of the deck. Cut again. And that card that you said stop at is somewhere here. But I guarantee you that we won't be able to find it. We're going to go through it like so. In this case, it was the Jack of Spades. And we can even count. Oh, there is a Jack of Spades. That's odd. It's like, but wait a second. The Jack of Spades has its center missing. And just a second, it was not in the... Wait a second.
Now we have in the card box the missing center of that same jack of spades. And the card to wallet obviously employs a wallet. Now you could have this wallet, if you will, in your coat pocket the whole time, or as I always did, I just pulled it out, left it on the close-up surface for all to see. You can have one, two, three, 10 rubber bands, it doesn't matter. You open it up, you show it empty, then you encase it again in the rubber bands. You no longer touch the wallet for the duration of the effect. Now, just as the other effect worked, the person selects a card by saying stop anywhere. In this case, we'll do it a little different. I'm going to get you to say stop.
Stop.
Right there. Not this one, but that one. This is the card she said stop at. We'll bury it into the pack. Spread the pack. You can shuffle the pack if you will. And it doesn't matter because that same card now they can go through and it's gone. It's vanished. They won't find it. And in fact, there'll be 51 playing cards. We remove the rubber bands and the card that she said stop at, that same King of Hearts, is now encased in the wallet. What I've done is I've turned over one card in four. I have four kings and four kings only in this envelope. King of spades, king of hearts, king of clubs, and king of diamonds. And you haven't been prompted at all as to which king to choose, but what you're going to do is you're going to go through them in your mind. King of hearts, king of spades, king of clubs, king of diamonds. And only one is going to stand out of the four. Only one. Name that one king.
King of Diamonds.
King of Diamonds. What we're going to do is we're going to pull out these cards and I'm going to show that there's nothing else in the envelope, only four cards. What card did you say?
King of Diamonds.
King of Diamonds. And believe it or not, we're going to spread out the pack and there is one card reversed amongst all four kings and it is indeed the King of Diamonds and it has a blue back. And this next one is called The Queen Speaks. And as the video suggests, as we're going to show you in a few moments, it was an effect that Grandpa Tom Kovnats did on my original TV show, Magic Mike's Castle. And I loved it so much. He's gone now, unfortunately. I thought we could share this with you with some variations included in the DVD. But very purely and cleanly, this is how it appears.
This one. Oh, we always carry on. All right. Now, which queen would you like to have do the talking for you?
Queen of Hearts is fine.
Queen of Hearts is fine. Now, what I'd like you to do is
Sir is the
make
Queen of Hearts.
Three cuts of the deck, if you will, please.
All right. Cut it three times or
Cut
is
it
it
three
three
times,
piles?
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that comes after two.
There's
One,
one,
two, three.
two, three. All right.
There we
Now,
go.
if you had your choice of these three decks, which one would you take?
I would take the full deck. No, I would take, say, that one.
You take that one. And I would take this one.
All
And
right.
what we'll do, we'll just take the top card of that one. And what I'd like you to do, I'd like you to take your queen and slip it underneath the card just far enough so that the eyes can see what the card is.
All
But
righty.
please don't flash it because that makes the trick too easy.
All righty.
Would you do that?
There we go. Her eyes are just beneath the card. There we go.
Okay.
I'm getting
now,
my deck ready.
Good. Now hold.
Good job, Sam. Good job.
Hold the card up to your ear and see if the queen is talking to you.
She is.
What is she saying?
She's saying Bubba's chicken soup is the best.
Yes, and what
else? The fish and jam.
Is she telling you what the card is?
No, she's saying don't plant your corn in August.
That's good advice.
You know what she just asked me?
What?
She says, what's red and goes ding-dong?
I know that one. It's a red ding-dong.
That's right. What's that? Oh, what's blue and goes ding-dong?
They only come in red.
That's it.
May I?
Specialty store.
She's saying to me, Magic Mike is not paying attention. The card is the Jack of Spades. Would you be good enough to turn over the Jack of Spades for us?
Sure. There it is. It is the same Jack of Spades that the Queen got. Terrific.
Now, that is terrific.
That's
you have
amazing.
To acknowledge that. Now, we have a master-sized card over here that we'd like... Perhaps in the magic of the magic castle, we can zoom in on this and see what that card is over
so
there.
So this pad is actually a card underneath?
That's right.
Let's have a look and see. It is also a Jack of Spades, a Jumbo Jack of Spades. Isn't that ever neat? Look at that.
Going to
That's
listen
amazing.
To what the Queen of Spades is saying, because she wasn't speaking to you. Apparently, she's speaking to me. She's telling me that card that you selected randomly... 1 in 52 is the Jack of Spades. Let's have a look and see if that's correct. We're going to turn it over. It is indeed the Jack of Spades, but not only that, the very same little map that we've been working on has a prediction. It is indeed as well the Jack of Spades. And that's called The Queen Speaks. It comes with numerous ways to have the person select a card and lots more bits of business. The Queen Speaks. To share with you another illusion which is completely original, and this one is called Which Witch is Which. We have a number of witch cards and a ghost card, and they reside in this castle little folder type of affair with a castle backdrop on the back and a picture of a castle on the front. And what's really, really cool is we have three witch sisters and one little ghost named Boo. And this is Helen, Zelda, and Griselda. Griselda, Zelda, Helen, and Boo. And the idea is to kind of try to keep track of where Boo is. And every time you guess correctly, we will eliminate one of the witches to sort of make it easy. So, where is Boo? And of course, it's pretty obvious that Boo is there. So we'll eliminate this one witch, that happens to be Helen. And we'll mix up the cards like so, just so that we can try to fool y'all. Which is which? No. Where is Boo? And Boo is over there. It's pretty obvious. So we will eliminate the next witch, which is Zelda. And we just have two cards left. We've eliminated Helen and Zelda. Now we just have Griselda, or Esmeralda, rather. And where is Boo? And it's pretty obvious that Boo is here, but guess what? Boo is not here. He's vanished, being replaced by the fourth witch sister. That's because Boo, like any good ghost, has returned back to his castle home. And there he is, back in the castle.
Thank you.
Come on, come on, wake up, wake up, it's a lovely day. Come on, come on, wake up, it's a brand new day. Sitting on our chairs, coffee in the air, and we just don't care. Come on, come on, wake up, it's a lovely day. Come on, come on, wake up, it's a brand new day. Walking on the beach, oh, ain't it nice? Sand beneath our chairs, coffee in the air, and we just don't care. Now we're old and gray, sitting on our chairs, coffee in the air. Helping people laugh.
grade one. Okay, do you like school?
Yeah.
Good, you keep up the good work, okay?
Okay.
All right, we're gonna do a little trip with a clown's nose. Now, you might have noticed, Kathy has a big, round, red, spongy nose there. Well, I have about 4, 5, 6, many of them right here in the bucket in my little cauldron. And I also have a magic wand to help us with this. Brittany, we're going to test your reflexes. I have to see how fast you are. So can you hold out your hand? When I touch your arm, close your hand real quick, as fast as you can. 1, 2, 3. Perfect. You're going to be terrific for this, I know. I'm going to let you hold on to one of Taffy's special noses right over here. It's big, eh? It's really big. Okay, open up your hand again. Take the nose, bring your hand a little closer to me. Atta girl, squeeze. And take your other hand, place it on top. Squeeze, squeeze as tight as you can, and don't open it until I ask, okay?
Yeah. Hey, look, I found a rubber band.
She has one nose. I'm going to take this one. Can everybody say go?
Go!
Gone? Did you see it go? Do you think Brittany has them? Let's see. Open up your hands and hold up in each hand what you have, honey. Open up your hands. How many does she have? She does have two of them. Let's clap for Brittany. She did such a good job. We'll have her try it again. Take these two tighter than before. Tight, tight. Put your hand on top. Perfect.
So,
Brittany has two noses. I'll take this one. Can everybody say go?
Go!
Come on. You think she has three now? Let's have a look, see, open up your hands and let's count them. Look at that, hold them up. 1, 2, and she does have three of them. Let's clap for her again. That is excellent. Let's share with you guys how that's done. Don't go away. Now I'll show you, all along you only saw three, but I really had one more right here in the bucket. I actually had four. And whenever I went into the bucket to get my wand like this, I fished around, and I always gave Brittany one more than I said I was. So instead of giving you one, I really gave you two, and so forth. So now that you guys know, let's try it one more time. Open your hand, and let's not tell them how many I'm giving you. Put your other hand on top, squeeze, squeeze. Who knows how many she has? I'll take this one. Can you all say go? She had 1, 2, 3. How many might she have now? She might have four. Open up your hand slowly, Brittany. And check this out. She really does have four.
Restless warrior.
sleep. Peaceful sage, whom do you keep?
Just lean back and let it go.